I know I'm type late, but I ain't gonna lie, but I've been seeing a little bit of shit here and there flowing, and I feel it floating around, and I feel as though I don't even know the backstory. I don't know what's going on, but obviously the title of the video should tell you everything I need to know. So we're gonna jump straight into this shit. See what the fuck is going on? It's late right now, it's 12 o'clock. This is about to be my last video I do before I go to bed. Matter of fact, I'm about to go take a class after this, then I'm going to bed. Let's
Who's
use
making a big splash on the scene?
Yes, sir.
Kelby is in the
Lil
building.
Kelpie, also known as Kelpie the P. A matter of fact, you can call me whatever you want, just don't call me broke.
Kelpie, though.
That's
Yeah,
right.
out here today.
And then
When you
co-hosting
say
with.
Kelpie, I think of Plankton from fucking. Word. From SpongeBob. I don't know why Kelpie.
Me?
Whatever.
Vic says Gerber Disclosure, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Almighty for the album, because the record too short, you dig what I'm saying? Though the real deal, you know what I'm saying? Holyfield, you know what I'm saying? Not the impersonation.
Damn, he just came with a whole little monologue like OJ.
Yeah, I was about to say.
That was fire.
The nigga could have said, didn't hear nothing. Not gonna lie to you.
Okay, so I wanted
but
to
I guess
like,
it wasn't for me
hop
to
in here and attempt to, you know, have a conversation that perhaps can build on some of the other conversations that have already happened.
Yeah.
So let's lay this all out. So
Pause.
You had a very, very viral appearance on Soft White Underbelly.
Yeah.
Tell me
Don't
what happened.
Those.
Like what was
Soft
your life like in the lead up to that? Why'd you decide to do that?
In the lead up to that, I was hustling. I don't want to say specifics, but I was doing a little shit in the streets, and then basically
Keep
I was like, you know
I
what?
I feel like you've already filled us in about what you were doing.
Yeah,
in the
I mean, well, Sharp made some accusations about what I was doing. I don't want to admit or deny those, but
okay.
Yeah, basically I was getting money and shit, and then that hustle came to an abrupt end when I got raided. So then I switched into another one because I seen some people that needed help, and you know, I just jumped into the game.
Describe getting raided though.
Oh, well, I was outside vaping and shit and, like, you know, still hustling. And the girls were inside and basically just got a no-knock raid. They came in, they pulled me outside some undercovers, and they, like, drew their guns on me and shit like that, put me in the squad car. And then they all just were, like, inside my house and, like, yo, we got a warrant to search.
Yeah. Don't know what was going on. I guess he was a pimp. Claims that he was a pimp.
I have a challenge for all of you. Go to every
Shout out to
computer
Mr.
in your
Beast.
House, your mom,
right,
your dad, your sister, your brother's computer, and
install.
Your person and your vehicle and your house.
But they were suspicious of you. Properly.
Yeah, they were trying to say that I was like, you know, drug dealing or something like that.
Okay.
And
but you don't have a case as a result of this?
Nah, I never heard back from them, honestly. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay. And so then
you
decide. You
know what's crazy? I actually heard about something like this before. A couple years ago, Lil Reese had did an interview off topic real quick. He had did an interview and said the feds had raided his crib, took all his jewelry and his money and shit, but he never went back to some shit like that to, like, wasn't a case or some shit like that. He never went back and, like, figured it out. He said he just brought new shit. Apparently, BMF had the same situation and the feds did the same shit with them, and then they tried to, like, get they shit back and do all of that. And I guess the feds ended up looking into them and shit like that. And then that's how they ended up getting indicted. And they started figuring out who these niggas were and all that shit. Crazy.
Like, how did this Software Underbelly opportunity even come about?
Well, I've been trying to do some, like, online stuff and just get that internet money and also promote my girl's OnlyFans.
Okay.
So basically, check out Crystal Roses on OnlyFans, by the way. She's going up. Basically, I was just trying to promote that stuff. So I went on Soft White, talking about my
Shout
story.
Shout out to
them. And then, yeah, that just kind of blew up.
Promoting
so what was the feedback like? Like, what would you describe as the most common comments that you saw in response to the Software and Underbelly thing that were really driving it being
Yeah,
bad?
I don't know.
Oh, just a lot of hateful shit about the way I was dressed, mostly. People was like, and also I feel like they took a lot of the shit I said out of context. Like, when I said I was homeless, that was because I just got evicted after the raid. The apartments had, like, kicked us out with some Section 8 that I was staying with my family and the girls. So they kicked us out of that, and then a lot of people were like, oh, why is he dressed like a Party City pimp, fake chains and all that, but, you know, it's all real. You know, the outfit, I feel like that's the most thing that people said was being disrespectful, but I was just doing that to get attention, but all my jewelry's legit and stuff.
So,
been diamond tested.
Suspect,
you know.
Fill me in on that. Like, is there something expected of you before you've earned the stripes to wear certain types of, like, pimp outfits?
So he is a pimp.
It was like, we felt like that shit, like, the equivalent for to get everybody to understand, kind of like blackface.
Whoa, shit got heated. Word. Kinda like blackface. I'm pretty sure this is a white young man, and you are African American. So to compare whatever he was doing to blackface automatically, crazy. Crazy. We got, come on, people. We got other analogies or come on. We could call it something else. I don't know what the situation is, but we could call it something else.
You know what I'm saying? Like that shit was kind of like it looked like a costume.
Maybe blackface wasn't it. Maybe, you know what? I don't know.
You get what I'm saying?
Right.
It's like he came in here wearing that shit like in his head, like, oh, this is what pimps is supposed to look like. I got my little dollar sign chain, my little fur coat.
Say he was appropriate. Yeah. That's what it sounded like. He was like, appropriate.
You know, you could have rocked the same fit or something similar.
Nah, they would clown you.
I'm true to this, so of course I could. But
you telling me the
same thing, like I'm black.
Yo, bro, these niggas get on No Jumper and all these people podcasts and interviews and just be telling on themselves, bro. I'm true to this and I'm black. I don't get the correlation. But I heard.
Blackface. You get what I'm saying? Like, okay. It's like wearing blackface.
But so
like,
but aren't there white pimps at these pimp conventions?
That's why I don't, of course.
Black white pimp.
And you didn't even know who he was until right now.
But
until
I know
who
he is. I know who
he is. We asked you that last interview. You had no clue.
You didn't ask me about no white pimps last time?
The nigga Sharp said, you know who the fuck white folks is? You was like, no, I don't. You didn't know who the fuck that was?
He told me who that was on FaceTime before the interview
happened.
Exactly.
You didn't know who white folks was until we informed you.
Until Sharp informed me on a FaceTime before this interview.
Until a pimp informed you who white... Exactly.
But you know what I'm saying? There's white pimps out there.
Until somebody informed him before his interview.
So I don't get how it's blackface.
Oh, they got tension. I'm getting the vibes that Sun feel disrespected because he a real deal pimp or whatever, I don't know, allegedly. And he's impersonating real pimps and niggas is not jacking Sun right here. And niggas, him and the Sharp nigga been on his ass and the internet been on his ass because they feel as though he not a pimp. I'm just pulling this little together. I don't know too much about this.
Somewhere doesn't need
No. That was just an analogy to get everybody to understand. I'm not saying that
blackface.
You were doing.
You said I was doing blackface.
To get
we
got to
get a better analogy,
yeah, because
bro.
You pulled up in a pimp costume.
He was saying it was like blackface, but is it the fact that he's white in general, or is the fact that he's
that's about blackface though too, bro?
It's just because he's not really doing that shit in his head. He came,
but I am really doing that shit. My pockets will prove that.
That's like. What's a good analogy?
Yeah, you gotta get
I just gave one. Like,
no!
Let's do another one. Like a nigga who go to the gym with all the shit, and he looking like he finna ball the fuck up. You feel me? And then when he get the ball, he can't do shit. But he came in his head like, this is what ballers look like. I'm gonna get the headband, the socks, and all that shit.
I agree with that. That's a bad analogy.
You get what I'm saying? Like,
what if,
that's
what
I'm
if he
saying.
Starts learning how to play ball, and then he starts balling harder than other motherfuckers?
Right?
Is he...
The white boy in your ass.
Still impersonating at that point.
Everybody's a little kid trying to be
like
Michael Jordan at one point, somewhere. Right?
And that's then, what you talking about? Word. Yeah. Talk y'all
you
shit.
You are Michael Jordan.
Yeah, Adam. Fucking y'all talking about.
So everybody starts somewhere. And I feel like y'all were hating on that because not even the race thing, because I feel like we're all the same, no matter what color we are. But I feel like it's because of my age and because of how new I was to the game that y'all just attacked me for
that
it.
That has nothing to do with that. I don't
really?
Feel like, I don't feel like you're
that's
new to shit.
That's not what it seemed like.
You hate white people.
No. I feel like you're not new to shit.
Adam, niggas watching Adam. Adam be instigating.
Shit, I just feel like you're an impersonator for your SoundCloud career. You're not new
there
to shit.
Say
bro,
that.
Bro, I don't even
here.
Focus on music.
You came up in
I
here
focus
talking
on
about
the streets.
You,
I focus on getting money.
Talking about you
I think him being white too definitely
like,
influences.
Yeah.
This.
We asked you
to
where you learned this shit from, and then you said, "Yeah, I watched you. I watched Sharp on YouTube." Like,
yeah,
get the fuck out of here, nigga.
Because I have no mentors in real life.
You could watch on YouTube and impersonate
and start getting money from
getting the fucking streets, nigga. And get
what
some
you think
real
I've been
experience.
Doing? For getting money,
but
getting
the,
experience.
All these
every
drill
day.
Kids
they
are
literally
looking at
arguing life. About incriminating themselves.
Hey, the drill rappers
experience.
And fucking getting
but
influenced
really
by that,
outside
right?
Drilling though.
But
now
he's
really
outside pimping.
Not really.
Not
really. I brought
Adam
some bitches with me.
Now,
I never seen none of your bitches.
That don't mean
he
shit.
He got some work on the couch.
None of your bitches.
Right.
None of your bitches.
Because I'm really doing this shit. What the fuck I look like bringing some bitches in here?
Really?
Feds, we got one. That's what they just said. We got one. Come on, bro. Y'all niggas get y'all easily get tricked out y'all position. I don't get it, bro. Why do y'all want to get on here and just tell yourself so badly, bro? It don't make
sense. You're a clown, nigga. You going to get life for this shit. You going to get life for playing around, nigga. I'm really doing this shit. What the fuck do I look like?
Bring it through.
Niggas get the book through at them for this shit.
We get money.
This nigga's a clown.
You a fucking hater,
bro. This nigga's a clown and impersonator, nigga.
You're breaking one of the rules of the game right there.
Nigga, you're a clown. Nigga, you're a clown, nigga. Fuck out of here. Nigga, you're a bum, nigga. Go get some money, nigga. You ain't no nobody track. Mr. Old School, you ain't got no fucking money, nigga. Pull the money out.
Adam is watching them. He instigated this shit. Now he's in awe. Nigga, you instigated this, bro.
Fuck.
You knew this was gonna happen.
And you ain't got no bitches. You ain't got no
fucking bitches. Look at this nigga, Adam.
I'll say that. That's cool.
You ain't got no bitches.
Because when the police watching, I don't have no bitches.
Now you don't got no bitches.
Let me just interrupt real quick.
I'm the only manager when the police
ride. Let me just interrupt real quick.
Yeah, you, bro. All
right.
When he said clown ass nigga?
People trying to pull that.
Manager when the police
ride. Let me just interrupt real quick.
Oh, he said
yeah,
that.
You, bro. All
right, hold on. People try to pull that out on Sharp and stuff too. Like, yeah. Where's your bit? I'm gonna be real. Like,
they
me and Sharp have been in the same group chat for like a couple years at this point. So I've seen some of the girls they spent time with. He definitely has some attractive.
Adam, tell him too.
I have no idea what their relationship is, but also, you know, you get to respect it. Like, fucking, if I had like all kinds of girls, I would probably try to keep some.
I'm not a street dude, but
professional life,
bro. It's really a drug out here, bro, that got y'all niggas minds, bro. Literally, bro, it got y'all minds. Come on, son.
I've been bringing chicks around, all my employees and stuff. I mean, I am someone who lives my whole fucking life on the internet, so it might be kind of different from me. But, I mean, just because he don't necessarily... I've seen some women trailing him before.
Yeah, right, Adam. Come on, bro.
Niggas really know, nigga. I'm on tracks. Boy, fuck out of here,
nigga. I ain't never seen no bitches.
Who are you?
I'm Lil
who
Kelpie.
No
Kelpie
one
the
knows
pimp.
You.
Kelpie the motherfucking
Kelpie
pimp.
The clown. Fuck
you ain't gotta
here.
Know who
hey,
I am,
fuck
bro.
Out of here.
Fucking Ben Franklin knows who I am, bitch.
Fuck out of here.
No,
he
knows who the fuck I am. I'm
you
getting money
what?
Every day. I
said
Ben Franklin knows who the fuck I am, bitch.
Who you calling a bitch,
Ben Franklin,
though?
I'm calling you a bitch.
Let's see if we can find the actual video real quick. Just the jumper fight. I don't know how YouTube gonna go with this shit though, right? YouTube might OD. Hopefully they
I really
seen
know,
it.
Nigga. Oh, no. I'm on track. Boy, fuck out of here.
I ain't never seen no bitches.
Who are you?
I'm Lil
who
Kelpie.
Are you?
Kelpie,
no
Kelpie
one knows
the pimp.
You.
Kelpie the motherfucking
Kelpie
pimp.
The clown. Fuck
you ain't gotta
here.
Know who I am,
fuck
bro.
Fuck out of here.
Girl. Fucking Ben Franklin knows who I am, bitch.
Fuck out of here. No.
He knows who
yeah,
the
that
fuck
bitch,
I am.
He ain't like that shit.
I said, Ben Franklin knows who the fuck I am, bitch.
Who you calling a bitch, though?
I'm calling you a bitch.
Okay, let's break this down. Spitting. He was, son right here was not prepared. I ain't gonna lie. He was not prepared at all. Soon as son got up, you were supposed to, the uppie was supposed to, you feel me, activate. You were supposed to get activated or tussle or something. You was not prepared, and I ain't gonna lie, he violated your shit. He's piecing, this is his first time being in the fight, and it's on camera on No Jumping. Adam, you panicking is mad funny. Adam panicking is mad funny, bro. Because you instigated this shit to a degree, and these niggas right here, he was not ready. He should have been ready because you called another grown man a bitch after y'all was already into it, kinda, sorta. He was piecing son shit up. You didn't throw one punch, I don't think. You were supposed to hit him with a three-piece and let him rock. Three-piece, no bacon, no fries. Three-piece with a side, bev and all that, then let him rock. You just hit son with like the five-piece combo. McNuggets.
You calling a bitch, though?
I'm calling you a bitch.
He lacks... I give him an F. Zero self-awareness. What the fuck, dude? Alright, YouTube, don't cancel me. I just had to watch that a couple times, man. Yo. Shit got wicked. Hey, man. Like, comment, subscribe, man. Hopefully next time, son, get, you feel me, he got a little bit more self-awareness. old boy was not jacking him from the beginning, so call him a bitch definitely said something over there. They both was wildin' though, I ain't gonna lie. They grown ass men, but you know. Man, like, comment, subscribe for another video, man. Check me out down below, man. Be easy.